warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. This is Ms. Linda. We'll continue with IB Physics Topic 6, Paper 2. Now here we have a small, let's read the question. We have a small ball of mass M is moving in a horizontal circle on the inside surface of a frictionless hemispherical ball. The normal reaction force N makes an angle theta to the horizontal. State the direction of the resultant force on the ball. Now here, I need to draw all the forces that is acting in the ball. Down, we have the gravity or the weight of the ball down. So here I have Fg or W down. Normal to the surface, here is the surface. Normal to the surface, I have the normal force, N. It makes an angle perpendicular to the surface. This normal force, I can break it down since it's with an angle with the horizontal. If I took this is the horizontal x-axis. So I can break it down into N cosine the angle, because this side is adjacent. Adjacent, always we use cosine. And perpendicular or the vertical axis in y direction, I will have N sine theta. Now, what are the forces that is responsible for circular motion? It will be N cosine theta. Fg and N sine theta, these forces, there are equilibrium, they're equal each other, so they don't have any effect on moving on the motion in circular path. So the only responsible forces that is responsible for moving in a circular path is N cosine theta. N, we can give it a simple also R, reactant force, or Fn normal force, the same. So this is F net. And it will be to the right toward the center. It will be toward the center. Okay. B, on this diagram, construct an arrow of the correct length to represent the weight of the ball. We just did it before, just draw an arrow to give you the weight of the ball down. C, show that the magnitude of the net force F on the ball is given by the following equation. Let's go back again. Here we have the ball here, and this is the surface. Down, we have Fg. Normal force is perpendicular to the surface. And this normal force, it's making an angle theta with the horizontal. So here I have N cosine the angle theta. And in y direction, I will have N sine the angle theta. So if I make X and Y component, in y direction, I don't have motion. So based on Newton's first law, summation of forces acting in y direction should equal zero, which means I have balanced forces. All the forces up should equal to the forces down. All the forces up, I have N sine the angle theta will equal to the forces down, which is Fg. Fg mass times acceleration due to gravity. In x direction, this is the forces that is responsible for the centripetal acceleration or centripetal force. So F net will equal, he call it F. So I'm going to take this first simple F will equal N cosine theta. Now I have sine and I have cosine, and in the formula there is tan. I know tan theta equals sine over cosine. So if I give this one equation one, and this is equation two, I can divide equation two by equation over equation one. So if I divide, if I divide n sine theta divided by n cosine theta, this will give me m g divided by the net force F. So I just divide equation two over equation one. N and N, they cancel out. Sine over cosine, it will give me tan. So I will have tan theta will equal mg divided by F swap. So F will be mg divided by tan theta. Okay. D, the radius of the pole is 8 meter and theta is 22. Determine the speed of the ball. Determine the speed of the ball. I can use the equation, centripetal force equation. This will equal mass times the centripetal acceleration. This value, it's from the previous part of the question, it's mg divided by tan, the angle theta, will equal m, centripetal acceleration, it's velocity squared divided by the radius, m and m, they cancel out. So I can find equation to determine the speed. Cross multiplication and take the square root. So I will have v squared will equal g times r divided by tan theta. Take square root for both sides and you will get v. So v will equal square root g is 9.81 or 10 times the radius is given to me, r equal 8, r equals 8 divided by tan the angle theta, which is 22 degrees, and this will give us 13.4 meter per second. That's it, girls. Next, we'll continue the rest of the question. The rest here. I have this outline. You'll explain it. Outline whether this ball can move on a horizontal circle path of radius equal to the radius of the ball. No, because we don't have a force to balance the weight in the horizontal direction. We'll do this one. Here you have the ball. Now is the ball is now displaced through a small distance x from the bottom of the ball and is then released from rest. The magnitude of the force on the ball towards the equilibrium position is given by mgx divided by r, where r is the radius. Outline why the ball will perform simple harmonic oscillations about the equilibrium position. The ball will go back and forth. Now, the condition to have simple harmonic oscillation, either force or the acceleration should be directly proportional with the position, with the displacement, and in the opposite direction. So if the ball is moving in this direction, there is always a returning force in the opposite direction, opposite to the direction of displacement. And show that the period of the oscillation of the ball is about 6 seconds. This is high level. 6 seconds, this we can use the pendulum equation. T equals 2 pi square root length of the pendulum divided by gravity due to acceleration due to gravity. And this is 2 pi. L is given to us in the question is 8, and G 9.81, and this will give me 5.7 seconds. This is the period of oscillation. That's it.